Everybody, Scal Crafter here again. First off, I want to thank everybody for all the love you've shown on that last Billings video. I'm glad you all liked it. It was a fun project. I want to introduce you to, this is Kenji. Kenji's a rescue. I found her actually under a bus about 5-6 years ago and rescued her, my cat. Anyway, today we got a nice screwdriver. A very rare Israeli-made screwdriver. We're gonna tackle, let's see if we can get that done. Thanks for
today's project, we have this nice little 16.5-inch screwdriver that was made in Israel. Now, I don't know if you could see it here. I'm trying to get, there here. It says stainless steel, so that's something. I see UMT there. But if you look over here, you could see here, stainless steel Israel. You see Israel? So it's made in Israel. You could see the condition of the handle. I mean, it took some beating, right? I mean, it has some wear. And over here, and I don't know if it's peeling. I don't know what that is. Do you see that on there? All that crud. And I don't know if that's the stainless. It can't be flaking off. It's stainless steel, right? So I don't know if that's some kind of weld spatter. I don't know what that is. But the tip, you can see the tip is a little rounded off. So we're going to have to work on the tip a little bit, but it's I like it, and I like it's red. What can you not like about it? So let's get started, see what we can do with this real quick.
Now you have to see, whenever you take your plastic handle over to a belt sander, it's very important. You got to move very quick. You can't hold the plastic to the belt for any length of time, or else you'll melt the plastic.
Okay, the belt sander, we got a lot of the major scratches out, especially of the high parts here. We're going to have to get in the inside, especially over there. You see that with the hand sanding. I got this nice and smooth. I got that was some kind of, I don't know what was on it, except I got one little bump here. You see, that's a weld splatter. So I'm going to try and file that off.
Now, I know this sounds crazy, but one of the most wonderful things you could do is to file a round surface with a flat file. It doesn't seem like it works. It works fantastic. Then we took the tip over and reground the tip on the belt sander to get it nice and square and everything straightened out. After that, we went to the slop sink, and pardon the look of the sink, but we spent about 20 minutes sanding it down, especially in between the grooves.
Okay, after about half an hour of hand sanding, thing wouldn't fit in my lathe because the blade was too big. We got this presentable, but not where I'd like to be. See those little scratches and everything? And you see where it is? Okay, it looks good. Don't get me wrong. But you know what? It could look better. And I think what I'm going to try, I never did it before, I'm going to clear coat this. Because when it's wet, these things really tend to pop. So let's see what that looks like.
Now, we sprayed it with one heavy coat. Then after that, we went over to the buffing machine and we finished doing that. Now, we usually do the blade before the handle, but I got a little screwed up on this restoration. After that, we used some metal polish to give it just that little bit of extra shine onto the shaft of the screwdriver. And you know my favorite part. You remember what this looked like before we started.
And we're calling this project done. Look how beautiful this came out, huh? I mean, I'll tell you, I am shocked. Even me, I'm shocked at how nice this came out. This thing looks like brand new. It's just, I'll tell you, and the shaft came out beautiful. You know, the stainless steel shaft, obviously. Stainless steel always comes out nice. And the tip, for the tip, we reground it so that it's flat and just, you know, really nice. So, really happy with this project. The handle, like I said, after I gave it that sanding and wet sanding and everything, really wasn't happy with the finish, so I gave it a shot of this Rust-Oleum Clear. And that made all the difference in the world. Now, I've never done this before, so I can't tell you how it's going to hold up, whatever. But I've been handling it and manhandling it, the whole thing. I've been, you know, it's been in my my living room for the past couple of days. And I've just been, you know, squeezing and holding it. So it just feels beautiful. It doesn't even feel like there's anything on there. But one heavy coat, that's all it took. So it filled in all those little micro scratches and everything. And it really came out like a fairly new screwdriver. So there we have the restoration of this UMT made in Israel screwdriver. kind of a rare model. I spoke to a friend of mine. He knows his screwdrivers, never even heard of it. So it's an unusual model. And I hope you enjoyed the restoration. Thanks very much for tuning in. Take care and have a nice day. Bye-bye.